Birmingham, welcome, if you will, with me as we bless the Lord tonight with the appointed and the anointed spiritual QC from Tupelo, Mississippi. The spiritual QC from Tupelo, Mississippi. Live in Birmingham. Glory. Hallelujah. Spiritual QC. Thank you.
gotta run. He'll get high, but I gotta run. Valley's getting low, but I gotta run. Step gets real slow, but I gotta run. Just can't make it. Heel all around. Anyway, coming behind. Ain't got nowhere to go, but I still wait. Look up, and I tell it, I gotta run. Have another story I want to tell you. Can I tell it? Somebody don't want to hear my story. Can I ask you one more time? Can I tell my story? Okay. I was reading the other day about a man named Moses. I was reading where one day God called Moses. Told him, said, Moses, I want you to go down in Egypt land. I want you to tell old Pharaoh to let my people go. And you know how that story goes. Moses began to kind of question God. Said, now, Lord, are you sure I'm the one? Say, you know, my tongue is a little tied and I don't speak real well. Lord told him, said, Moses, all I want you to do is just go and I'll go with you. Just open your mouth and I'll speak for you. Moses went on and told Pharaoh what the Lord had said. But you know how that story goes. Pharaoh's heart was hard, and he wouldn't let the old peoples go. Well, after God had brought several plagues upon the land of Egypt, he called Moses again. Said, Moses, I want you to go back and tell old Pharaoh, if he don't let my people go. Tell him there'll be a great cry in the land of Egypt. Tell him that all of the firstborn in that land will be killed. And then, Moses, I want you to tell your people, I want them to kill a lamb. I want them to put the blood on either side of the doorpost. So when the death angel come and see the blood, he'll pass that door by. Moses went on and told Pharaoh what he said, but he wouldn't let the old people go. And the Bible tells me it was midnight when there came a great cry in the land of Egypt. All of the firstborn in that land was killed. That lets me know that God moved at midnight. I got another story. Can I tell that one? Talking about the five wise and the five foolish virgins. When they went out to wait on the bridegroom. And you know how that story goes, don't you? The foolish ran out of oil. And the Bible said it was about midnight when somebody cried out, the bridegroom has come. I got one more. I got one more. And then I'm gonna leave you alone. Talking about old man Paul and old man Silas. When they were bound down in that Roman jail, didn't have nobody that could go their bail. Now, can I imagine just a little? I imagine old man Silas had been troubled ever since that jailer closed them doors. And I imagine after he had taken all he could take, he looked at Paul and told him, said, Paul, oh, Paul, don't you think we ought to sing a song, a prayer, prayer? And you know how it is. If you ever been in a situation where you knew that everything was going to be all right, but somebody else was all trouble and tore up about it. See, Paul had been in Rome, and Paul already knew that at midnight, all of the Roman guard would go to sleep. But he knew that the God he was going to call on never sleep. So I imagine a little bit again. When Paul looked back at Silas, he told him, said, Silas, oh, Silas, let me tell you what we gonna do. We gonna wait till the midnight hour when all the Roman guard go to sleep. We gonna wait till the midnight hour when it's just Jesus, you and 'cause he's the only one I know that can deliver us and save our soul. Let's wait until the midnight, till the midnight hour. Let's wait till the midnight, till the midnight hour. Come on, let's wait till the midnight, till the midnight hour. Can I say one more thing? Till the midnight, one more thing. Sometimes I love to be in company. All along, so I can talk to my heavenly Father up in heaven on his throne. I can call him in the morning, noon or night, but anytime I call him, oh, it's all right. But I'm gonna wait till the midnight, gonna wait hour. I'm gonna wait till the midnight. I believe I'll wait hour until midnight.
Wait till the midnight hour. Wait. Can I have one more privilege tonight? I want to call somebody else. Yeah, now I done called my brother, my uncle. Now, I got a friend I want to call. If it won't make nobody mad, I just like to do that. That will do my night. Y'all have made me happy, but if I can call him, that will make my night. Y'all, can I make my night? Anybody seen Mr. George Dean? Would he come this way? Will y'all give him a hand for me? Now I don't know for sure if I can get him to sing, but I'm gonna try.
If you know
you've been born again, say
I do.
One more time, one more time, one more time. Anybody loving?
I do.
Anybody loving?
I do.
Anybody loving?
I do.
Anybody gonna serve? Do you love
it?
Are you gonna serve? Do you love
it?
Anybody gonna serve?
I
do. Do you love
me?
Somebody call President and tell him, can I get somebody to write Congress and tell them, does anybody here know how to contact the House of Representatives? Tell them. But do anybody here, can you get a message to the Supreme Court? Tell them. Do you know the judge? Will you tell him? Do you know your Senate? Will you tell him? Will you write your representative? Tell him. Tell your mayor. Tell your Congress. Tell everybody. The man who went in the grave stayed three long days, but he rolled with that victory. Grave gave up the victory. Devil lost his thing. Jesus lived again. All power in his hand. Won't you tell him from me? Everybody see. Tell him that Jesus is alive and well. And everywhere you go, you tell him
he's alive.
Tell him
he's alive.
Just tell him. Jesus still lives. All I need, all I need is one witness that know he still lives. One witness that shown up know that Jesus still lives. I wonder if anybody here tonight ever got up early in the morning. You started looking, but you couldn't see your way. You kept on looking, but you just couldn't. See your way, and then after a while, you went down on your knee, and you looked toward heaven and called on Jesus, and Jesus stopped by and made a way. got no headache, no stomach ache. I'm talking about real sick. When you laid there, and kept laying there, and kept laying there, the doctor came, turned and walked away, and he told you he couldn't do you no good, but you kept on laying right there until after a while.
Yeah.
Somebody ought to tell him thank you. Somebody ought to tell him thank you. If you know, when you laid down last night, slept all night long, when you realized you couldn't watch over yourself, and when somebody stopped by your bed and shook you early this morning, and you look around and find out your bed wasn't your grave, and it wasn't your seat, wasn't your winding sheet. Somebody ought to tell him thank you. 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 Somebody here know he's been good. He done done something for somebody in this place here tonight. Nobody is good. I already know he's been good to me. And you know, I was just watching one of those programs on TV today when it said adopt a little child overseas. And then they showed the little children up on the screen, and some is too big in one place and too little in another. Some dehydrated, can't even make tears to cry. Some malnutrition done sit in and they can't even stand up on their own little legs. And then when I think about how my children get up, go down in the kitchen and pick it and choosing what they want to eat, I said, thank you! Go on and give it to him. Go on and give it to him. Whether you know it or not, we already owe it to him. For all those many years we went and didn't even stop to think about who was doing what, we owe it to him. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. For my legs, thank you. For my feet, thank you. Somebody can't do this, thank you. Sometimes it looks like the harder you try, the harder things get for you. And the same one you go all out of your way to try and help, You find out that's the one on the other side of town right now, already putting your name out on the highway and out on the head. But you know, when you already know somebody don't like you, it just don't bother you so bad when they do something mean to you. But the one that stand up in your face, one that shake your hand with one hand, smile in your face and stab you in the back all at the same time. I don't know how it makes you feel, but sometimes it makes me feel like I want to just throw up my hand. Because I don't know which way to go. Then I go home, sit down, put my face in my hand. And then my mind go back to how long he's already kept me. How far he's already brought me. How good he's already been to me. And that's when I just get up on my seat, raise my hand and tell him, Lord, I can't live. Lord, I can't give him now. Sometime I don't have no money, but I can't give him now. Sometime my shoe get thin, but I can't give him now. Sometime my own loved one don't understand me, but I can't give him now. Sometime my own children may tear roll down my face, but I can't. I can't give up now. So I stood away, threw up my hand, and I tell the Lord, I can't give up. I can't give up now. See, I've come too far to turn. Turn around now. Can I say it again? One more time. I can't give up. I can't give up now. You see, somebody else here know you. You come too far to turn. Turn around now. One more thing. See, I've come too many. find myself standing at the crossroad in my life. Standing there just wondering which way should I turn? Seems like every time I turn to my right side, I find trouble, confusion, misunderstanding. It's already on my right side. And then I turn to my left side, find out somebody's sick, somebody's in the hospital, somebody done passed and gone on. And every time I look, I see healed, and more healed that are already waiting on me. Make me feel like I wanna just fold my arms, sit down somewhere and just moan. But then when I began to take inventory over my life, turn around and look back, and I see all the hills, I see all the mountains, I see all the valleys. God has already brought me over, and that makes me know. That makes me know. So I stood away.
Thank you. We're gonna do an old song. Y'all give us a hand, we get ready to do this.
Jesus is all
over me.
All over me.
Sure,
it ain't nobody
There was two men fishing for their family. Told them to give up right now. Drop your nets, take up your cross, and follow me. That's when he looked at them and he told them, he said,
let's go fishing.
Down by the sea, there was two men fishing for their family. Told them to give up, do it right now. Drop your net, take up your cross, and follow me. Fishing for me.
Fishing.
When you show a little love,
let's go fishing.
When you go out of your way to help
let's
somebody,
fishing.
When you sacrifice yourself to do it
fishing.
For somebody else. And I tell you, the best bait can you. Anybody ever heard of love?
Let's go fishing.
I ain't gotta ask nobody about it.
Let's go fishing.
'Cause I remember a few years ago. Nobody else. And I remember one day when somebody dropped some bait right down beside me. I looked at it, got up, and went on my way, y'all. But one day, when looked like nothing would come together for me, everything was going wrong. And I figured if I tried this bait one time, it couldn't be.
Thank you.
Somebody in you that's shown up, know you. Jesus said, I'll make you bishop of me and me. Thank you. Thank you.
Hold on.
Sinner boy, sinner girl. You better make peace with your maker. Meet your undertaker. So don't you wait too late. Don't wait till they roll you down. Down the aisle.
When it's too late. It's too late.
When you're torn.
It's too late.
Been glued to the roof of your mouth.
It's too late.
Heart doesn't stop beating.
It's too late.
Pumping blood from one vein to another.
Well, it's too late.
a smile, and when trouble comes, everything is all right. That's what she'll say. She's up early in the morning, sometime late at night, doing all she can to make everything all right. 'Cause you know there's no pain, 'cause love
will go
all the way, say it again,
love will go all the way.
Song remind me of a story where a young man had gotten in trouble, been tried and found guilty, sentenced to hang by his neck until he was dead. But in this country, they had a custom. They had a bell, and that bell must ring before they could take a man's life. And the old lady knew that. So the night before her son was going to be executed, she got up, went out, climbed up, and made her way up in that bell. Early the next morning, they brought her son out, stood him on the raft, tied his hands behind his back, put the rope around his neck. Officer looked at the soldier and told him to ring the bell. Soldier pulled, but the bell wouldn't ring. Told him again, said, ring the bell. Again, that soldier pulled. But the bell wouldn't ring. Soldier told the officer, I believe something must be wrong in that bell. Officer told him, said, pull a little bit harder. Again, that soldier pulled with all he had. That bell wouldn't ring. Then the officer told him, said, well, untie his hand. Take that rope from around his neck. We've got to let him go free. When the old lady heard that, she forgot all about where she was. She just turned loose her hold. Fell to the ground. Her son walked over and said, Mama, you didn't have to do that. But she was laying there, she had tears rolling down one side. She was smiling on the other side. She looked at him and said, son, there's something I've never told you. But I want you to know that I love you, and I'll do anything to see you go free. The officer was standing there. He was so amazed until he turned to the other officer and told him, say, you know, I learned one thing today. And as they began to walk away, he began to explain to him what he had learned. He looked at him and told him, said, I learned that love will go
all the way.
Somebody know it will.
Love will go all the way.
How many shown up knowing we are? How many came looking for something tonight? How many entered this place looking for something from God tonight? How many looking for something from God tonight? Well, how many know he's already here right now? How many know he's already walking up and down the aisle right now? And he came to bless you. He came to bless you. He's already reaching down to bless you. But you gotta reach up and claim your blessing. Somebody said, well, what does reaching up have to do with anything? How many know when you reach up, you're already saying something? When you reach up, you're already saying something. Don't take my word for it. Go home tonight. Turn on your TV. Watch the police chase the bad guy. And when he gets tired.
There's a parade of Easter and spring fashions for the whole family at McKinney's Unique Fashions in Tupelo. Get high-style looks for work, church, and special occasions. Girls' triple ruffle dresses with matching accessories. Boys' suits, short sets, and accessories. Ladies' fashions include suits and dresses by famous makers, plus designer hats, purses, and shoes. For the men, double-breasted suits, colorful sport coats, tie sets, dress suits, and pants, plus shoes by Stacy Adams. McKinney's Unique Fashion, 606 North Gloucester, Tupelo.